Hi there, I'm Michael Oliver from Sunderland in northeast England. I'm proud to be a part of the Dental Mavericks group that's heading over to Morocco, actually 3 days' time. Lucky enough to be off work today, so just doing a little bit of greenhouse work. And this is my this is my normal life in England. What a contrast with what I'm going to see next week. Can't wait to see the kids again. I come from a big practice in Sunderland, working with 30 people, and I'm off to North Africa on Saturday, joined up with the Mavericks. I'm going to see the children and help them with the dental problems. I just want to take a moment to describe some incredible generosity I've found in the last year from patients and friends and acquaintances in the Northeast who've been contributing towards our trip to Africa to help treat the children of Morocco with their dental problems. Standing here with a whole load of Sunderland shirts, we've run a project in Sunderland to gather Sunderland shirts to take over for the children. We've had an enormous amount of money donated. The staff at work have been fantastic. They've been fundraising with car boot sales. We've had fundraising days at work, all contributing to in excess of £10,000 towards the children in Africa. So I'm heading to Africa with over 200 Sunderland shirts to give out to the children. And I've got a pocket full of money for them as well, so can't wait.
And I think a lot of people always ask, what is a dental maverick? Well, a dental maverick is a giver. There might be a dentist, there might be a dental nurse, there might be a dental supplier. But also, if you look at the dental mavericks that that come on these expeditions, is that they support other charities, the big givers. They're active in the local community and now they're active in the global community, and they share a real purpose. It's not just about making money, it's also about helping others because they can.
And finally, just on that, after this third trip, we're looking at putting a sustainable oral hygiene program now into the school, whereby we've raised money through a great organisation called B1G1, where we're now raised enough funds to go back and put in some utilities or facilities for the children to be able to brush their teeth at school, which makes it sustainable, and also to complete our final project of having a dental ambulance with a fully fledged up and running clinic on there as well. So it's very exciting times.
Hi, it's Michael Oliver from Sunderland, delighted to have met up with the Mavericks. First stage of our journey here, we just landed in Spain and heading over to Morocco tomorrow. But just as we landed in Spain, unfortunately we've just heard a bit of bad news that a couple of the main parts of the trip, one back home, the people of Sunderland have been incredibly generous handing in Sunderland shirts for me and the team to hand out to the children of El Jebah, the little village we're visiting. And unfortunately, along with the Sunderland shirts, a lot of the medical supplies that we've kindly had donated by Henry Shine, a tremendously generous gesture, have been stopped at customs at Heathrow. So we're in a bit of a turmoil here because a large part of the provisions we were taking into Morocco unfortunately haven't arrived, which is not great news. So we have what we have.
It's, what day is it, Wednesday morning, and we've now spent 12 hours in the offices of the customs trying to sort out the paperwork to get the trailer out of the port. We'd spent 4 hours on when we arrived and another eight hours yesterday, and we're going back this morning to, fingers crossed, get the authority from the final guy who wasn't in yesterday. He says it'll take half an hour, so let's keep our fingers crossed that that's going to happen. And then we have to go to Chefchaouen to get another piece of paper from the Minister of Preparation to travel with the trailer. So in comparison to the last year, we had nothing like this. We just basically got the authority from the bat and we were away. So completely different experience this year and not what we expected. But fingers crossed we'll have that. We'll have the licence and we'll trailer out of the port by lunchtime. Watch this space.
Hello, Callie.
Hello.
can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. Yep.
Am I on loud speaker now?
Yes, you are. You're on speaker.
Hi,
you're on camera.
Hi, everyone!
Hi, Gally.
We got to the port this morning, and the man, Rashid, turned up with his uniform on today, with his white crisp shirt and his epaulettes, so we knew he knew business. And he'd already been for the last piece of paper that we needed yesterday when the man was travelling. So he turned up with the stuff and said there would be no problem. And when we pulled through the vehicle, the policeman that was there the other day wanted to pull all the boxes out again and go through all the boxes. Really nervous because we hadn't said we would donate the dental chairs because of the cost, and we wanted to bring them back.
Yeah.
So we were scared in case he was going to say, right, well, you can't have the dental chairs. So we had from that to spend it took 2.5 hours basically.
Right.
And there was a problem with it because we had released the car and they hadn't given us the trailer paperwork as well.
Yeah.
That we had to go back and sort all that out, and then eventually then the Rashid came and gave us the white paper and we could leave the port.
Excellent.
Brilliant.
Thanks, Kelly. All right. I'll speak to you soon. All right.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
What a difference a day makes. 24 hours, I think I was talking to you. 24 hours ago, I was talking to you, and I've got to be honest, I felt pretty down. We'd worked very hard the last few months to build up supplies for the children in El Jebah here. And at the last minute, we found that we were having great difficulty getting those supplies through. But today, as I stand here, all the supplies are parked over the road there. We're just about in half an hour to go and visit the local school, and we can do all the work that we planned. So this is my third year here. I can't believe the welcome that we've got. We've got friends here now. We're coming into Morocco, into a primitive little village, and I can't wait to see the children. So it's all good. It's gone from what looked like bad news to fantastic news. So we're going to have 2 days helping the children of El Jebah with the big dental problems. I've got some fantastic colleagues with me, and I can't wait to get started.
New clean instruments, but they're not sterile, so I'm going to pop them in the disinfectant solution before we start, so that we do at least start with them.
That means I'm going to organise with God in such a short amount of time. I can't believe it. It's like a proper little workstation, we've got a workflow. We're good to go.
Problem. At the moment, yeah, we are waiting for the product we need from the hospital, from Chowan, and they should be here at 10 o'clock. It's now 10:30, and they're not here yet, so soon the kid's going to come, and they can't start to work. They need that, how do you call it? Anesthetics, yeah. So they are phoning now the hospital in Chowan to ask what time they left there, because they should be here.
It did arrive, you know, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
Bonjour.
Ça va?
And then we've done the tops, now we need to do the bottom. Ready? So this way and this way. Yeah? So who's next? Let me see. You. Come on. Come see. Right. This way. You see?
par régler les bouches et les dents et toutes les choses. Asseyez-vous, prends les chaises.
Et on va dessiner.
This afternoon was really difficult. Lots of kids and lots of pain. One particular wee boy that Jazz and I really struggled with. He had a big, huge abscess. His mum was concerned with sepsis, so we wanted to get the tooth out, but he'd had trouble with a dentist here. He was tiny, he wasn't even four, and we struggled getting the anaesthetic in. Getting the teeth out, people were holding the wee soul down, like it was absolutely mind-blowing. Like, I mean, obviously we're all professionals, we've all done difficult extractions, but I don't know what it is about these kids. Like, they're so beautiful, and like they just look at you with these massive eyes, and it makes you want to just take them all home and look after them and make sure they get no sugar and no crap so they don't have to sit through stuff like that, because it's awful. It's terrible for us, terrible for them, I mean, but like trying to just work on these kids and just try and make them better, you know, it's so difficult. The wee one, we managed to get one tooth out, but we didn't know if it was the E or the D. So we made the decision to take out the E, and we knew straight away that it was the D, and there was no way we'd get back in to take that. So we lanced the abscess, and it was just a case of hoping for the best. But the mum was so grateful. Like, I can't believe how grateful these people are for what we're doing, which is so little in comparison to what really needs to be done, you know?
Hello, it's Michael Oliver from Sunderland at the end of two fantastic days with the Dental Mavericks in Morocco. I'm a proud founder member of this charity amongst friends here, the Dental Mavericks. As I say, the third year that we've come out here. The first year we were unsure what we were going to find. We were doing dentistry in school classrooms for these children. Last year things improved. We have a clinical facility. And this year things have moved on incredibly due to a tremendous amount of generosity from people back home. We've been able to come this year and offer more. We've been filling teeth for the first time rather than just taking teeth out. Obviously we've spent a lot of time taking teeth out. These children have got incredibly decayed teeth. They've got dietary problems. Nobody's looking after them. So I know it's just a small gesture from us, but we've managed to do an awful lot of treatment in the 2 days we've been here. So
It's been a pleasure. These kids are absolutely wonderful. They're all running around in Sunderland shirts now. And I've really enjoyed myself. And thanks very much.
So, what we can say, this is the third round for the Mavericks Association. Really, it's perfect, nice. People is very, very happy, so. And they smile. They smile with a new tooth, really. So, we thanks the Mavericks Association for their helps us here in Morocco, for especially in Jebah town. So, thank you very much.